Assalamu alaikum, hope sure you all good. This is Saeed Khan. In this video, I'm going to show you how easily you can submit your research article to a journal. Okay, first of all, if you are used to with submission of your research paper, then it's useless for you to watch all the video. So it is only for the fresh scholars who don't know how to submit a paper to a journal. Okay, before submission your research paper, what you have to do, first of all, prepare a file without the information of your name details and your co-authors as well as I'm just showing you my file. You can see I have the given name of the file. The file name is like article without author's name. You only can see here I have just a title of the paper and abstract and introduction and hold the paper. So so you must prepare a file of your paper without the name of the authors. The reason is that as we mostly submit our paper in blind peer review journals, actually the editor send the paper to some two or more than two reviewers, and for this it is necessary that there should not be any kind of information related to authors. Okay, please make another file. You can see I have authors detail. In this file, mention all the necessary details like name of the authors, email address, and affiliation of the author and all. You also can mention here who is the corresponding author in your paper. If you need this file, you can contact me. You can contact me via email or WhatsApp and Skype and so on, what is convenient for you. Okay, now prepare a third file, that is cover letter. Cover letter means you're just preparing a document in which will communicate with the editor of the journal. You can see here at the top I have mentioned the date, current date. Well, it is the name of editor-in-chief, as I'm submitting my paper in Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism Research. I will not say that all the time type Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism Research. Mention here the name of that that journal in which you are going to submit your paper. Okay, let's suppose you are going to submit your paper in Asia Pacific Journal of Social Work and Development. Then type here Asia Pacific Journal of Social Work and Development. Now it's a name again of editor. You can see here I'm saying that dear editor, I'm submitting a paper to the current issues in tourism. It's by mistake. You have to mention here the original name of the journal. Means I must paste here Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism Research. I'm enclosing a submission to the Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism entitled Asymmetric Impact of Exchange Rate, Inflation and Oil Prices on Tourism Demand in Pakistan. New evidence from non-linear ARDL. It's the title of your paper. Now, I'm also acknowledging that my co-authors and I don't have any interest that might be interpreted as influencing in the research. I'm also saying that we don't have a conflict of interest, any kind of a conflict among the authors. Now, you also can see here, I have clearly mentioned we means our authors don't have any kind of disputes and so on. Also, I have acknowledged here that all the authors contributed equally. And if it is the requirement of the journal, you can also suggest few referees, means some reviewers, as I have suggested Noman Arshad, Dr. Tahir Suleiman. Okay, what is this? Remember the document I'm showing you, all are dummy. I have basically this title, Asymmetric Impact of Exchange Rate has all Rajiv published in Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism Research. So I'm just want to show you that how you can prepare all the documents. Again, all the document I'm showing you are dummy. So if you need any types of document, you can email me. I can send you. I have no problem. Close it. And now last file, you have to prepare your table and figures in a single file. You can see here our result. I have managed all the tables and figures in a single file and okay it. Now what to do? First of all, search the name of the journal where you want to submit your paper. Let's suppose I want to submit my research paper in Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism. Go to Google, type Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism Research, search it. It is the link of the journal. Click on this. Before submission of your paper, you must see the guideline for the authors and see either the formatting of your paper is meeting the criteria of the journal or not, and all others the instructions of the journals you must follow it. As I have already published my paper and I have followed all the instruction of the authors. Now I want to just submit my paper. Click on submit an article. I have done it. Okay, now as I have already submitted my paper to Asia Pacific Journal of Tourism Research, then I have already user ID. But let's suppose you are a new scholar and first time you are going to submit your paper, then click on create an account. Then okay, select here. Let's suppose Mr. Saeed Muhammad Saeed. And let's suppose my address is okay, it's my address. Type the okay. Then you have to fill all the required file. Now click on. Now what to do again? Okay, saying your email address is already exists. So what to do? Just click on next and you will find other fields. So fill all, and when your accounts procedure done, then okay. Okay. Let me start from logging. Let's suppose I have just created my account. Now I want to submit my paper. So what is procedure? Simply go to let's suppose I just log in into my account and I have recently created my account. You can see here begin submission. Okay, click on this. And one more thing, we are submitting our paper with the help of Scholar One manuscript. Lots of giant publishers follow this, like Emerald and other as well. Okay, now from very first of all, select full length article. Let's suppose if you select special issue, as we're not submitting for the special issue, we're submitting for the regular issue. So click on first one. Here type the title of your paper. Let's suppose XYZ, not saying to type XYZ, it's dummy. So type your original title of your paper. Write paste here abstract of your paper. Remember one thing, you only can add maximum 100 words of your abstract. So let's suppose it's my abstract and click on save and continue. Remember, let's suppose you have performed your first step and you also can stop here, and after some time you also can start from here. And let's suppose here we have a second step. You can see you have to upload your files. Select here. The first option is title page. I have selected it, and then select file. Click here. Asking from us where we have our file, as we have a submission folder. You can see here. Here is the author's detail, in which we have our title. And from second, select main document without author's name. Here we have a main document without author's name. And from here, choose tables, because we have prepared a separate file for tables and figures. Select here, tables and our results. We have our tables and figures in this file. Okay, fine. Now what you have to do, you have to upload these files. So click on here, upload files. It will take some time, and after this, your files will be uploaded and will be saved, and you can proceed. Okay, it's taking time. This the speed of internet is slow, that's why you have to wait. Okay. Now the files are uploaded. Let's suppose you want to remove some files. Click here, remove option, and click here, remove option, and you also can change the order. Let's suppose you want to give you want to take the author's detail at second. Click on second and update order. Okay. Now I want to go further. Save and continue. Type here your keywords. Asking from us maximum, we required 4 minimum and maximum content. Let's suppose as keywords means whatever you have mentioned in your research paper in abstract. Let's suppose A, add, B, add, C, add, D, add. Now save and continue. Okay, when you will create your account, a system also asks you about your keywords. It means your system asking from you your favorite area. Let's suppose you are working on tourism, or you're working on a panel data or time series. So you can start. In this step, you can see by default I'm the corresponding author, because I have just uploading all the files and performing all the steps. Therefore, I'm here corresponding author. But let's suppose some cases where we have other authors as well as. So what you have to do, as you can see, you don't have any option for the adding other authors. So what you have to do, search author with the email address of the author. Let's suppose the email address of the author is this @gmail.com. Let's suppose it's dummy. You can see Saeed has there is no record for the Saeed. So what you have to do, create a new co-author. Remember, I will not search with the ID of author, you will not find this option. So you have to find, you know, with the help of your co-author's email ID. Create new co-author. Now from here, his doctor or Mr. or whatever, let's suppose M, let's suppose M, Ali. Fill all the required fields, and asking about the institution, let's suppose superior. Superior University, and okay, institution. That's okay. Here, hit up institution and country select. It says Pakistan.
city which was Lahore, and no need to do anything. Here you can see the authors here. Also, you can add as many as you have co-authors by searching one by one for all. Okay, now click here and save and continue. Okay, now in this step, you can see here, write your cover letter. So as we have already make our cover letter, so we have different types of options. Like first one, you can also copy paste all the material here, or if you wish to choose your file, simply click on select file and drag your file. Okay, now asking, is there funding to report in this manuscript, as this journal is we have two types of facilities in this journal. The first one is open access and the second one is limited access. So for open access you need to report funding, but for the limited access, as we don't pay, so we have no need to say about the funding report. So here I will say no, because I do not have any a third party which will pay for the paper, because I'll not pay and I'll not publish it open. So it's limited access, so I have no need to pay. Now asking, has this manuscript been submitted previously to the journal? Say no. If we'll say yes, it means you are submitting your revised manuscript. But if we'll say no, it means it's your fresh paper and you have not submitted it previously. Okay, after this, okay, let's suppose it's your revised manuscript, click on yes and paste here your paper ID, as it's the first time, so we are saying no. Confirm all options. You better read first. Is this manuscript submitted to the consider for a special issue? No, we are submitting it for regular issue. From here, confirm it. Number of figures, let's suppose 2. Table, let's suppose 7. Words, let's suppose this. Okay, I'm not saying you also mentioned here 2, 7, 3, 4, 4. It is just because I have already submitted my paper. That's it. Okay, click. You have to check all these two options and save and continue. It's taking time, really sorry for the speed issue. And now it's our last step, in which you have to review all the detail you have given to system. Like in first step, you have mentioned the title of paper, abstract, and you can see here your files and keywords and your co-authors and all the details. You can review. Let's suppose you find some mistake. Only let's suppose you find a mistake in keywords. Click on keywords and you will find the window and you can edit again. After this, click on view PDF and click on view this one. Now you can see the submission button is enabled. If you will click on submit, your paper will be submitted, and within 1 second you will find a acknowledgement email from the journal that we thankful to you for choosing this journal and your paper is for editorial process ready and so on. Okay, as I'm not submitting it, I'm not clicking, because if I'll click on submit, then my file will be uploaded and which are already published. So guys, hope sure you enjoyed this video, and thank you so much for being with me. Take care.